for it. We are discussing about class 11 physics chapter number 5. In this lecture, we will discussing about that the equilibrium of a particle. It means there are the different particles are there. Okay, sorry. There are lots of particles are there. So if we have equilibrium, it means there we have summing of the all the particles, and then we are getting the what will the equilibrium on the particles are there. So see here in the force phenomena we will considering that the equilibrium of particle in mechanics referred to as a situation when a net external force on a particle is zero. It means there are the different forces, the different kind of forces apply on the different on the particles on the of that particles. So on that time, how much force is applied on that phenomena? If something is rigid body are there, okay. So see here, suppose dusters are there. On the dusters there are the put in the benches. So it is in a rest positions. Why? Because something force is applied on that, but the net external force is zero. That's why it is a rest on the table. But suppose we are putting that the values if we are putting on the slope on that time, it will be going to down. Why? We are not doing the any kind of force, but it will be going to down. So on that time there are the it's a momentum of that. So what now, first of all, I already explained to you what is the momentum, but in this lecture we'll discussing about that the why this phenomena is happen. So on that time what will happen, why the duster will goes to the down, because of there are the something is frictions of that. So it is a not a it's a proper momentum, or it is something of frictions are there. That's why it will be going to the down. So see here, but suppose if we are putting on the slope on that time, there are the it will be raised on this position on that time. How why this happen? Because of the momentum of its momentum is very much stronger than the frictions, so it is not going to the down. So see here, according to the first law, this means that the particle is either rest or in a uniform motion. So if two force F1 and F2 act on a particle, equilibrium requires. Or what is mean that the F1 it is equals to minus F2. So it means that the frictions and the force of the momentum it is equals to same of that. So that's why F1 it is equals to minus F2. Okay, so there are the action and reaction. We know about that the action and reactions will be different. Action and reaction will be same on that time, the value will be same. So it will be same. So see here, the two force on the particle must be equal and opposite. So equilibrium under the three concept of force. Suppose there is the first one is that the two forces are there. Here suppose it's a three force are there. One or the, what it means that the F1, F2 and F3 require that the vector sum of the three forces, that it is equals to zero. F1 plus F2 plus F3 it is equals to zero. It means there are these three forces are there. It will is equals to zero. See here, there are the F1 and F2 in these directions, and also so in other words, the resultant force, see here, the other two forces are there, F1 and F2. In this direction, it is F3. So F3 in this direction, okay, it is a parallelogram, the resultant force is at here. On that time, what will happen? That on that time, there is a F3 is there. So it is a force F3, and this is our resultant force. Both the forces will be same. So that's why these things is remain on that positions. So in other words, the resultant of any two forces, F1 and F2, obtained by the parallelogram law of force must be equal and opposite to the third force F3. So as in figure, see here, the three force in equilibrium can be represented by the sides of triangle with the vector arrows. So see here, this is also there the side of vector arrows. In the same scene, the resultant can be generalized to any number of force. A particle is in equilibrium under the actions of force F1, F2 and up to Fn. So if they can be represented by the sides of closed and sides polygon with the arrow detected in the same sense. So see here what will be seen from the equations 5.11. where is the equation 5.3? This is our equation 5.11 are that. So due to the equation 5.11 are that, see here there are the force in the three directions are that. So f1x plus f2x plus f3x. So it means there are the in this three different things is that in the x direction. Then after f1y plus f2y, and also there are the f3y forces apply on these y directions. And also when what will happen? The f1z, f2z and f3z, it is equal to, so this is all about the zero. So f, where f1x, f1y and f1z are the component of a f1 along the x, y and z directions respectively. So it means what will really happen? What do you mean by that? So it means there are the net external force will be zero. Okay, net external force will be zero on that phenomena. It means suppose something is three different.
There are rope are there, okay.
So what will happen? There are the two teams are stressed to him sides, okay, or her sides. On that time, what will? There are the two teams are, though both are trying to get the rope in our sides. So that's why there are the equal and opposite force are apply on that phenomena. So it will be not going to any sides of that. So this is the basic things of that. So this says that the resultant force is equal to zero. Okay, suppose one team will be won on the, it means that the, it will be, it has a more force than the another teams. So this is the basic thing of that. So see here, of this is our topic is that equilibrium of a particle. It means the force, what we are applying the force, it is equal to zero. Okay, so what we have applied, so it is equal to zero, then the equilibrium of a particle force. So this is our f1, f2 plus f3 are z, it is equal to zero. Now see here, the common force in a mechanics. Now see here, our another topic is that common force in a mechanics. So in this lecture, in this topic we will understand due to the PPT. Okay, so see here. So guys, see here, we all know about that, what is the force. A force is the push or pull acting on an object that change the motion of the object. So see here, we have, there are the types of force are there. See, first one is the contact force are there. So contact force is meant the force that act through the direct contact between two objects. Applied, there are the forces that applied force and or of frictions are there. Second thing is that long range force. Okay, long range force that can act over the distance. It means there are the gravity, electromagnetic force there. Okay, so this is the example of that. Now see here, we know about that the Newton's second law of motions. Newton discovered the idea of force. He found that the force is proportional to the acceleration of an object is or more F, it is equals to force, it is equals to more accelerations. Now he found that the force is proportional to the mass of object. So see here, you know about that, the Newton's second law. So moving for object accelerated when the unbalanced force F act on them, the strong the force, greater the accelerated A, also the greater the mass M, the greater force is required to change the motions. Now force is equal to mass into acceleration. So F is equal to MA. We know about that, the second law. It's a vector quantity and therefore the has a magnitude and then directions. The directions of force is the same as the direction of the acceleration. Unit is that. Newton is equal to 1 kg meter per second square, and Newton n is defined as the amount of force required to the accelerator 1 kg of mass at a rate of 1 meter per second square. But now net force, when multiplying the force are acting on an object, the net force is the amount of force that is left after adding all the forces on the object. So we know about that, just we are in the previous topic we were discussing. So now net force F net is equal to resultant force F of R. Now then after we are discussing about the balance force. Okay, balance force are, it means the force that are equal and opposite so that they cancel out. So suppose we are applying the 10 force in northeast and 10 newton in the east and 10 newton in a west side. So on that time the net force are there. Net force is equal to plus 10 minus 10 is equal to 0. Now suppose unbalanced force act that when added do not cancel out and cause a change in the motion of object 13 newton east and 20 newton in west. So it means the 30 newton minus 10 newton is equal to 20 newton east. So inertia, we already know the inertia that measures the tendency of an object to resist change in motion. So Galileo come up with the idea of inertia. Object do not want the motions to change the mass change, or mass measure how much inertia an object has. More mass is equal to more inertia. Now equilibrium. We already just run it now, understood that the first condition of equilibrium is that net force acting on the object is zero. It means the net is equal to zero. So acceleration A is equal to zero. So the object is either stationary, V it is equal to zero, or traveling with the constant velocity, V it is equal to constants are there. Mass and weight. Mass is the amount of matter that an object possesses. Mass does not change with the locations. Weight is the gravitational force that a large body, such a planet, exerts on another object or that. So this is our weight. Is that weight is a force. It is a measure in a vector. And weight is equal to mass into acceleration due to the gravity. Newton's second law. W is equal to m into g. That. Now weight does not change locations. G will change with the locations, but weight does not change with the locations. But solving the net force problem, make a free body diagram, MFBD, force and then acceleration on an object. Use the following equations for the solving of the unknown values of that. So F net is equal to FAX, F net is equal to FAY, and F net. Now, see here, we have another topic that frictions. So, what is the friction? See here, friction is resisted motions. Okay, friction causes moving object to slow down. Friction produces heat. Okay, whenever your high hand will be doing the warm, what you do? We are doing the hand, touch to hand and rubbing the hand. Okay, so multi time. So on that time, what will happen? Your hand is getting the heat. So static frictions occurs between the stationary surface and at contact. Then after sliding frictions occur when surface slides over another. And rolling frictions occur when a rounded surface rolls over the another. So there are the three types of frictions are there. First one is the static frictions occur when the stationary surface is contact. Second is the sliding frictions occur when a surface is slides over the another. And rolling frictions occur when a rounded surface rolls over the another. So see here. Way to reduce the frictions. How to reduce the friction? Use the wheels or rollers. Lubricant to produce a smooth layer between the surface. Okay, so we have known about the lubrications. In the TV channel, in the television, we have shown that the lubrications advertisement for the oil. Okay, the reducing the frictions. So that's why lubrications, it means we are adding that we are greasing the our roller instrument. Okay, so wheels are rollers instrument. On that time we need to require the lubricants. And also we have known so that the shutter of the saw on that time, what they are doing, they are doing to greasing the shutter slidings. So on that time they can easily pull up and pull down the shutters. So this is the basic things of that. So use wheels or rollers and lubricant produce a smooth layer between the surface. Standing the surface. Now see here, friction is a force. Newton's law applied. The friction causes acceleration, slowing down the motions of an object. Frictions always act parallel to the surface in the opposite directions of motions. And now, calculating the friction force depending on the frictions depend on the friction force acting between the surface, normal surface, and nature of the surface coefficient of the friction. Now see here the normal force F of N, it is minus a force that act perpendicular to the surface and away from the surface. So the normal force F of N is usually found by the summing the force in the y directions. Now coefficient of the friction, we will describe how the rough smooth the surface or rough surface high value of mu is greater than 0.5 and smooth surface low value of mu is less than 0.05. Now the frictional force is the product of the coefficient of the friction and the normal force are there. Friction force is equal to rho coefficient of friction multiplied by the normal force F. So F is equal to mu into F of N. Now free fall, the situation where the gravity is the only force acting on the object, assume no air resistance, the force the air applies on a moving object, it attempts to slow down falling objects. So similar to the frictions are there. Now the air resistance and the terminal velocity. The maximum speed of falling object reach when dropped from the east. See here, now object reach terminal velocity when the force of gravity is balanced with the force of object. Now see here, terminal velocity. The terminal velocity is the maximum speed of falling object is when dropped from east. Now see here, an object reach from terminal velocity when the force of gravity is balanced with the force of air resistance. Now seeing that an object is dropped and the force of gravity W is much greater than the force of air resistance. So see here, gravity is, we have taken that the value of G, but here we are considering just for the W. So see here, that is much greater than the force of air resistance F is FAR. So it is W is greater than F of AR. So the force of air resistance increase as the speed of falling object increase. Now see here, eventually the force of air resistance is equal and opposite to the force of gravity and the net force acting on the falling object is zero. So the F of FW is equal to F of AR. Therefore the F net is equal to zero. And also, since the net force acting on the object is zero, the object continues to fall but falls the rest of the way at a constant velocity in Newton's first law. The velocity is called the terminal velocity. It means that since the net force acting on the object is zero, it means the object continues to fall but falls the rest of the way at the constant velocity. So, Newton's first law, this velocity is called the terminal velocity. So f net is equal to 0 and f of f is equal to f of ma and therefore a y is equal to 0. Object fall with a constant velocity, so the terminal velocity can be a maximum or a minimum velocity at that. Now see here we see periodic motions of simple and harmonic motions, but here we are not considering that. Now see here, we are discussing about that the springs law. What will happen when you are applying the force on a spring. So the Hooke's was a scientist of that. He was derived the spring Hooke's law. That's why we are talking about that. They are deriving for the springs. So that's why we have taken that the Hooke's law. The force on a spring is proportional to the distance from the equilibrium positions. It means that there is something is force stored in the spring, and on that time what will happen. So f of s is equal to k of x, where f is the restoring force of the spring. So the force is restoring in the spring, and how much is restored, the displacement from the equilibrium positions, and also it is proportional to the spring constant of for the particular springs are there. So the period of spring is that the find the period of spring ts is the simple harmonic motions. So t of s it is equal to 2 pi under root m upon k square root is that, where what is the m is the mass of spring and k is the spring constant are there. Then after we are discussing about that the pendulum is a mass attached to the spring of or wire of length l that swings back and forth through the equilibrium positions. A pendulum swings through small angle in example of SHM. See here, gravity is restoring force and is proportional to the distance away from the equilibrium positions. The component of gravity change as the pendulum moves back and forth, resulting folding F is proportional to the D. So the period of the pendulum can be found with the TP. This is an example of that. So T pi under root L upon G square root, the period of the pendulum depends only on the length and the accelerations due to the gravity. And after we have another force, is that force on the ropes and the strings. So what will happen? There are the tension. Is that force acting along the rope or wire? Is that our tension? The tension always act away from the object along the rope. And the Newton's third law applies to the tension by looking at two objects are there. So only one tension need to be drawn on a free body diagrams. Okay. So guys, thank you. If you can't understand in these lectures any kind of things, so then comment in the comment box. Thank you guys. Thank you so much.